In this video, I'm going to be talking about why Robert De Niro's performance in Raging Bull is a masterclass in acting. Raging Bull is considered one of the greatest films of all time, and so much of that is owed to the fantastic performance from Robert De Niro, which is really one of the best film performances ever. Not only did he get into the physical shape of a boxer, of a middleweight, like the character he played, the real life middleweight champion Jake LaMotta, but he also gained 60 pounds for the third act of the film, and he also gradually was gaining weight throughout it. So in the middle of the film, his character is slowly gaining weight. On top of that, learn how to be a boxer for the fight scenes in the movie. But, you know, of course, gaining weight, losing weight, and a physique is not going to do the acting for you, even though it was definitely part of the character. You know, often he's talking about having to lose weight, put on weight. So that was essential. But, you know, this character, Jake, was a brutal guy. He was self-destructive. He was violent. He was violent against his wives. He was violent against his brother. He was incredibly insecure, easily jealous, didn't know how to communicate very well. You know, he was a rough guy who basically spirals out of control and self-destructs. But then, I think it's hopeful in the end that he knew he had to change. For a guy in the way in which he brought up, in what he did for a living, that him knowing he has to change shows he has some kind of morals. And that's really comes from that 70s filmmaking of, you know, unlikable lead characters who are complex. The audience can empathize with to an extent. So it's an extraordinary film. But the scene I really want to talk about is the jail scene where Jake LaMotta is arrested and put in prison for having an underage girl in a club that he starts to run when he moves to Miami. And he's put in jail for that. And this scene, you know, I just want to talk about De Niro and this anger that he is capable of. As Martin Scorsese says, he doesn't know where he pulls some of these performances from, but it is rage. It is fury. It is so raw, so emotional, really grabs the audience by the throat, and you really feel what he's feeling. As I've said in my Marlon Brando videos, who is also an actor who could really make you feel what he's experiencing, there are good actors, there are great actors, but then there's the master of the craft, masters of the craft, and De Niro is certainly one of them. And I just want to illustrate my point by looking at this scene where he's put in jail. For one thing, they're really pushing him in there as he's fighting back, and they're cursing at each other. They throw him in the prison, they're calling him an animal, and he shouts back at them, tells them off, he's not an animal, and stuff like that. And as it begins to build to this moment, the whole film, I think, because Jake in this scene breaks. This is when he breaks down. He begins to punch the wall slowly. And I don't know how De Niro didn't break his hands, because he's really punching that wall. I know it was a rubber wall, but still, I mean, he is breaking his hands against these things ferociously, punching as he gets more and more emotional, and begins by saying why, and he begins to cry as he's punching it and scream, and it's a breakdown. It's witnessing a breakdown. And Scorsese shoots the whole scene with these beautiful shadows. It almost looks like film noir, so his face is not always even visible. And it makes it scarier. It makes it horrific and dark. He just keeps saying, I'm not an animal. I'm not that bad. I'm not that bad. And here's a guy that you suddenly empathize with, even though up until this point in the film, we've seen him do so many atrocious things. But De Niro just, you know, he's capable of making you empathize with even the worst of characters, and that shows how great of an actor he is. And, you know, he also brought a lot of humor to the part, particularly the dynamic between him and Joe Pesci. There's a lot of really dark comedic parts throughout the film. The combination of, You know, of course, the physique, the building the muscle, the fight scenes, the gaining of the weight, the transformation externally, but also definitely the performance, the responsiveness, the depth that he is able to go to and express through Jake LaMotta and the comedy. I think that's really why this holds up. You know, it's a wonderful story, but you really needed an actor who could really, really perform and really, really let loose and really commit to it and go all out. I mean, it was really the only way. They had to shut down production for like quite a few months so De Niro can gain 60 pounds, which Erwin Winkler, the producer, said, no, we'll put prosthetics on you. And De Niro said, no, I have to feel everything that my characters feel, so I'm going to put the weight on. And no one had done that at that point. And we've seen so many actors since have to gain weight for parts, for better or for worse. Christian Bale's done it so many times. Matt Damon's done it, several actors. And I think now we've got to this point where Gary Oldman, for when he played Churchill, said, no, give me the prosthetics. And so now everyone's like, yeah, why are we gaining the weight to begin with? Then again, I think makeup's come a long way. You know, back then when you looked at the prosthetics, it was always noticeable. As great as a film as Citizen Kane is, you can tell the makeup pops out. I mean, I know that that's 40 years before Raging Bull, but I can't recall a performance where someone had to wear prosthetics at that time. But I think even if it looks so good, De Niro is just that kind of actor who wants to go, you know, all the way. I think people are looking at that differently now than then in regards to what an actor needs to do or should do for their parts. But it was certainly a time when he felt that you really had to go all the way, become a boxer, become a cab driver, and in order to understand a part. And that's just the way he worked. But apart from that, what a performance, what a film. It's one of my favorite films. It's inspired so many actors. Sean Penn, when I interviewed also Chris Caldovino, who was on The Sopranos, he talks about working in a movie theater when he was young and seeing Raging Bull and that making him want to be an actor. A lot of actors I've spoken to when I asked them on my podcast, who inspired you to become an actor? De Niro's always someone that pops up. And I think it's these kind of parts and these kinds of performances that will always hold up and are always, you know, universal in a sense. I mean, no one's perfect. We all have flaws, and we all, I think people really, it's so hard to look at oneself and want to change something we don't like. And for a guy like this, it's almost impossible. But I think people really respond to that. Audiences really respond to that. And we've responded to that since the 40s when you looked at film noir. I mean, film noir, the characters were always about that. Always about morals and facing who you are and those kinds of themes. So, but De Niro is fantastic. I love this film. I reviewed it on my podcast earlier this month. If you want to see it, the link is in my description box below, so you can check it out there. Thanks so much, everyone, for watching. Again, if this is your first time here, or if you haven't already done so, please consider subscribing by pressing the Robert Bellissimo at the Movies logo that you will see floating above my head to your top left. Click on that, and then click the bell in order to get a notification every time I release a new video or go live. Thanks so much, folks. I'll see you soon.